Hi, Seven. In this lesson, we're going to learn about gravity and what that means for our solar system and the planets in our solar system. So gravity is an attraction between two objects. So you might be thinking about gravity and how anything that you have, if you drop it, will fall to the ground. And that gravity is something that stops us from flying around. It keeps our feet grounded so that when we jump up, we also come back down. But gravity is actually a little bit more than that and a little bit more complicated than that. So gravity is an attraction between any two objects. In fact, it's an attraction between all objects. So this object and this object, there is some sort of an attraction between them. Between you and the Earth, there's an attraction between them. So not just from you to the Earth, but it's actually an attraction from Earth to you. It's a little bit like a magnetic attraction. Okay, these two magnets, they have an attraction towards one another. Now, these two magnets are the same size and they have the same mass. Now, because they have the same mass, their attraction to one another is even. However, if we have something, two objects with different mass, there's still going to be an attraction there, but the object that has more mass is going to have more of a pull on the smaller object. So the smaller object is going to feel more of a pull towards the bigger object than the bigger object towards the smaller one. And this is exactly how gravity works for us. So our relationship with the Earth has so much mass that we don't feel the Earth pulling up or being attracted to us. Because we are so tiny and have such little mass in comparison to the Earth, we feel ourselves getting pulled down. When we jump up, we feel ourselves getting pulled back down to the Earth. We don't see the Earth move. We don't feel the Earth move up towards us, but there is an attraction there. Now, this attraction is so important for why our planets revolve around the sun, and why they stay in their orbit around the sun. Now, the other thing about this attraction of gravity is distance. If you have two magnets and they are really, really far apart, then the attraction is really weak. But if you have two magnets, the closer you bring them together, the more attracted they are. And you can actually feel it when you're holding the magnets, how much they want to come together. Okay, so distance, if the distance is really massive, then that means that the attraction between them, the pull of gravity, won't be as strong as if they're closer together. So we're obviously really close to Earth, we are on the Earth, and so the attraction is quite strong for us. If you are out in space, the attraction is going to be a lot less because there's a big distance. And the distances are really important when we start thinking about our solar system as well. The other thing that is affected by gravity is actually your weight. So I don't know if you've ever noticed, but if you look at astronauts on the moon, they look weightless. They can jump really long distances and they sort of look like they're floating along the moon. That's because they actually weigh less on the moon than they do on Earth. Why is that? That is because weight is actually to do with the force of gravity. So the force that is pulling you down. Because the Earth has so much more mass than the moon, if you stand on Earth, the pull of gravity is stronger, so you weigh more. Your mass doesn't change. The particles your body is made up of is the same. That's your mass. But your weight, the force of gravity on your body, is much more on Earth than it is on the moon, because the moon has less mass. It therefore has less of a pull of gravity, and so you would weigh less on the moon than you do on Earth. So if we had to write a definition about what gravity is, what would we write? You might like to write something along the lines of gravity is an attractive force, or that everything is attracted to everything else, or that gravity is an attractive force that pulls you to the center of the Earth. That's a good definition, but it doesn't account for gravity out in space and why the planets are in orbit. So I like the sort of definition that gravity is an attractive force between all objects. So if we're talking about gravity being this attractive force, then why does the moon not just fall to Earth? We talked about gravity being an attractive force where the pull of the thing with larger mass, so in this case the Earth, is going to have much more of a pull on the thing with smaller mass. So even though the Earth will slightly be attracted to the moon should be super attracted to the Earth. So why doesn't the moon fall to Earth? I'm going to create a little demonstration for you to show you what actually happens in space. So here's another demonstration of gravity. So remember, gravity is an attraction between two items of mass. So any object has mass, and the attraction that is formed between them is called gravity. Now, this is a ball bearing. It's quite heavy, okay? So it's got a lot of mass. This is a relatively similar sized ball, but it's really light, okay? It doesn't have as much mass as this. So what would we expect to happen here? The object with more mass, we would expect that it would have a stronger pull on the object with less mass. So probably this lighter ball here is going to be attracted towards the heavier ball, the one with more mass, much more than this is going to be attracted to it. So we can show that here by, if I put our heavy one down and put this one here, what's going to happen? So straight away you could see that the orange ball moved towards and was attracted to the silver ball, the one with more mass. There's still an attraction the other way as well. So the silver ball would have had a pull towards this lighter one. It just wasn't as much of a pull as the other way. But then how does orbit work? How do planets orbit the sun? And in fact, in the same way, how does a moon orbit a planet? Like our moon, how does it orbit Earth? Why does it orbit Earth instead of just crashing into Earth like this? When the planets were formed, because of the nature of their formation, they weren't just plopped in a spot. Actually, there was momentum behind it. And what actually happens is that we talk about the space-time continuum being bent. So here, let's say that this whole black circle here is our space-time continuum. And when mass enters that space-time continuum, it slightly bends it. So you might not be able to see it as clearly, but there's a little bit of a dip here. There's a bend in our space-time continuum. And so if I now enter this ball, not just dropping it in, but with a bit of momentum, we can see that it actually orbits around the silver ball. It goes in a circular motion. It doesn't just go straight down. And that is why our planets orbit the sun, and it's why our moon orbits the Earth. Here's another example. So I've got a ping pong ball. So very, very light, not a lot of mass, but bigger in volume. Okay, so the actual size doesn't matter. It's the mass that matters. And so again, if I put this into a space-time continuum, we can see that it orbited around our smaller silver ball that had a lot of mass.